Previously on the channel, we've reviewed this, the Radialed Rapid Light Fitting from JCC. It is packed full of some innovative features, but the one we're going to look at today, it says on the box here, it's 2.5 times faster to install.
Did somebody say rapid? I'm on my way. Thank you very much. Ha ha, rapid light fitting and rapid gas, the perfect match, I would suggest.
You're right, Gary. And in eFIXX tradition, you know that we love to put fast products, possibly save electricians time, versus alternatives that you could install.
Okay, so that means I've got the light fitting from JCC that's got my name on the box, and I'm installing that one then.
And the great news is, Gary, you're also going to have to race with yourself against the alternative product that you could have to install when thinking about bulkheads. So, it is time to watch Gary race himself. And we're off. It's the Radialed Rapid versus this mystery bulkhead that we acquired from a well-known retailer who covers both the trade and the DIY market and has a click and collect service.
The Radialed from JCC already comes unassembled, so that's the first thing you don't have to do is take it apart in order to prepare it for the surface in which you're installing it. It's got a lovely tray as well, Gordon.
It has, yes. Yeah. So you can simply unclick that from the front with this just small retaining catch, and then everything is on that front gear tray. You've got the LED module and the driver. Put that safely to one side so you're not going to get drill dust and other debris in, or you may want to store it in a longer first fix installation.
You'll notice the mystery one is out with the very small Allen key, just about long enough so you can get them undone, but puts a lot of pressure on your fingers.
Yeah, and that was actually supplied with the fitting as well, so there's a bonus tool you didn't expect.
Yeah, if I've only got a longer one. I've got to drill and prepare the holes now in the back of the JCC fitting. So four mil holes in order to do that. And then I'm going to punch out a 20 mil hole in the back of it. You'll notice on the mystery one, I'm back out with a screwdriver because that tray has 3 screws holding it in.
It does, yeah, it's got the screws. But again, the driver stays on the back plate. So yes, you can unplug the LEDs and put them to one side, but you've still got to deal with that driver.
Yeah, so we're in with a 20mm hole in the back. The keen-eared amongst you might hear the fact that I left it on hammer. When you twist those on, it tends to move it around.
Yeah, but luckily all the conduit entry points in this fitting are marked very clearly with a small dimple in the middle for the pilot drill. The same can't be said on the other one, where strange that the driver seems to be in the area where you want to bring the 20mm hole through, Gary.
It was a concern, yes. So the driver, if I came through from the back, there's a great chance I'm going to drill through half of the driver. So I'm going to have to take out a screw or two here in order to move that to one side. I'm into the packet of the JCC for my grommet and screws, and they all use the Phillips 1. So the screws that hold the front on and the back plate are all using the same screwdriver. Nice touch.
Oh, that's good. Yep, so we're already mounting that on the wall and you're still unscrewing the other fitting. Yep, you're going in with the first screw. So you're just going to show us one here, Gary. I think we know how to screw something to a wall.
Yeah, where I can, I've tried to reduce the length of the video just from a point of view of screwing things in. You've got to put 4 screws in it. Let's see it get onto the wall. Likewise in both of them. So 20mm hole now into my mystery fitting. Not quite so easy, though.
No, a bit of a problem, yeah, because it isn't marked out for the pilot drill. You're actually on the bit where they injected the plastic when they made it. So I thought it was going to slip off there.
Yeah, well, I was a little bit concerned. So grommet's now going in. You get 2 in the packet with the JC radial lead. I'm only going to need one of those. So I wonder if that other one will come in handy later on.
Might do, yeah. So yeah, just put that into place. I mean, yeah, you're well on with this install and you're still drilling holes in the mystery product. Oh, just move that driver out of the way with a drill there.
I didn't think you'd notice that. Yes, so I nudged it out of the way. Good job I didn't catch any of those cables. Been wrapped around my Makita drill. So effectively now the JCC fitting is just required to be second fixed. So strip off my twin and CPC cable. I'm going to make those connections again. I'll speed this up slightly on both of them. I'm sure we know how to strip cables, except I'll take a couple of attempts here. This could give the mystery one a chance to catch up.
You're on there. You're on there. Let's see. Hold on. You've just... where do you get that grommet from for the other ones?
I found one on the table. There was a spare one from the JC radial lead, so I went for that one.
Very good. Well, yeah, you got to use it. That one came with a normal stuffing gland. Yeah, didn't have anything for the entry from the back with the cable. So you're well on. Are we putting your earth sleeving on there?
Yeah, my CPC sleeving on. I'm just now going to put my tray back in. Nice, yeah, clever.
That just clips into place, and then we're into screwless terminals.
It's the future, I think. It's about time everybody caught. I've just pushed my conductors into place, and I'll just put my connector strip then back into the appropriate slot so it held in place on the back plate.
Yeah, we've got loop in, loop out facility on there as well. And again, it's great being able to remove that connector block, bring it forward, do your wiring, then just nicely nest it back in.
Obviously, I did these two races separately, but at this stage, I thought I have a little bit of time to do a little bit of dressing. I didn't feel under too much pressure.
Oh, no, you're backing yourself there, Gary.
I'm backing myself. I'm backing the fitting, actually. It's almost putting itself on the wall. Yeah. This is great now. So I've only got to locate it. First time I've ever fitted one, so of course, I've got to get in the right position, Gaz. Come on. Yeah, that's slightly off-center. And just click, pushes back. Something satisfying about that.
So again, no screws needed for that. If you did need to remove it, just press the tabs in again. It's easy to get back at. You need to access the wiring or do some maintenance.
And you look at the mystery one, I'm still at the process of stripping off the twin and CPC cable. I've got my cover on now, on my JCC fitting, and it's just those screws to apply.
Yeah, four screws. Yeah, that's it.
And again, you don't need to see all of these going, okay, as we shorten the video out on both sides.
Yeah, where there is straight comparisons. It does have a decorative trim that we can put around it once we've finished it. Covers the screws and obviously creates a very nice, neat looking fitting. Yep. The other one doesn't have those, okay. But that's it. Your install's done on that.
Yeah, we have. That's it. Nicely finished. Oh. Just gently press that stop button and that one's done.
So meanwhile, back over at the mystery fitting, you're stripping your wires there. See, we're going to be going into some screw terminals.
Yeah, but look how quickly I stripped those two. First time attempts on both those. I'm catching up now. I would suggest
so you're
going
to double them over because you've got time on your hand?
I would have done, yes, if I'd have, no, I didn't actually. I left them single just to make a straight comparison. And I think they're a bit long as well.
Well, yeah, I thought you were going to do that because, it looks like you're going to have to chop those down a bit.
Yeah, I am going to chop those down a bit.
There we go.
Yeah. Okay. Well, it's quicker than doubling. I was trying to keep the comparison identical. I didn't double them over in the radial lead fit in for JCC. Okay, so here we go. Do you think screw connections are going to catch on?
Well, I don't know. Some people still like screw connections, but I'd rather go with a screwless one myself. Imagine you were doing this and you had two wires to get in there. You're looping in and looping out.
Just fumbling around to get them in. You notice the driver's still hanging freely underneath the fitting as well.
Yeah, you've got to do a reassembly job soon.
Yes, I have. I've got to find all those little screws and pop them all back into position. CPC is just secured in back, obviously fully insulated fitting, so it doesn't require the protective conductor, but we'll pop that one back in. I think you'd mentally now be thinking, well, what's happening to the person that fitted the JCC fitting? I would suggest they're either fitting another one or maybe they're doing a completely different job.
Yeah, they're wondering that. So you're just putting the driver back in. So find that. What did you do with that screw?
It was a very tiny screw. Notice we've just moved on a little bit there in time once I've found it. So pop that into position. Always tricky, isn't it? You know when you drop them from height especially.
Yeah.
You look one way, it goes the other. So that's my driver back into position.
Yeah. I'm going to bring the circuit board back in with the LEDs. Even subtle differences there. You'll see the way the light distribution on the JCC one works. They've cleverly positioned those LEDs. On this one, they're all over the place, so it's just all shining straight out through the front of the fitting.
All right, I've got to balance that now because I'm now going to go off and find the screws that hold on. They're three very small screws, and the comparison now here is a little bit different. Obviously, I clip my tray on to my JCC radial lead.
Yeah, this is where the time saving really starts to come in because you've got those tiny screws, and there's interest. There's four holes in that circuit board, but only three screws, and now you've got to try and find out where they line up to.
And they are fiddly. There is not much play in them, so I'll start getting them in, but they are fiddly to align with the holes in the back.
Top tip, it's the ones with a black circle around next time.
Yeah, well, remember, this was the first time I took both products out of the box as a fair comparison, so there was a little bit of a learning as you go here.
Yeah, so you got one in, so you're just going to sort of balance it while you look for the other screws.
Yeah, and you might say, well, straight comparison.
Yep, there's one of them.
Okay, I'll try to style through that one. Yeah,
I think we've lost the washer as well.
You didn't need it, it was extra packaging, so I'm going to pop those on. Because the other one just clipped into place, I'm showing all three of these screws going in because that's a difference between the products.
I'm pleased to show them because I think you dropped them a few times.
No, just the once I think I dropped it.
There we go. Yeah, nearly there,
It was a difficult process in order to get them in there. But once you've got them in there...
You'll drop them on the floor again.
Maybe it was twice.
Yeah. Imagine if you're up a ladder. You wouldn't be happy.
Yeah, so it's an element of pressure. I wanted to get it done in the fastest possible time. Okay. Yeah, only one of them's called rapid.
You've just got to put the cover back on. What, with more screws?
Yeah, but because we've got fixings on both of them, I'm going to not show you all the effort I put in with that Allen key.
That's it. Oh, lovely. Just always make them just a bit too
They
short.
Fit themselves, those Allen key heads. Yeah, lovely.
There you go. Yeah. Nearly there.
You can't do them all tight at once, though, can you? You have to work your way around, don't you? So there we go. All done.
Done.
I think that was pretty conclusive. Two things there. I won the race. I just want to note that down for the eFIXX team, that I won the race. And when you looked at the two time clocks, I think it was about 2.5 times quicker than it was to install that other one. Now, that was a nice touch as well. Yeah, the Allen key. I must suggest that I'm not in love with tiny Allen keys.
Certainly not. And also, I'd argue that the JCC fitting behind us actually looks a lot better than that alternative product. And one of the reasons for that is the clip-on bezel.
Yeah, which I've got another three in front of us here. We've got the chrome, the satin chrome, and the black eyelid one. I'm going to put you to work. I want you to take this one off, and let's fit this black eyelid one in its place.
Well, that looks pretty simple. So I'll just take that one off.
Yeah, there you go. And you can fit this new one for me.
Okay. And just also remember, we brought the cable in the back of the product on the one we installed. There is also the option to take a conduit through, obviously, the body of the fixture, but also through the rim itself.
And that's obviously good because we clip it onto that clip over the conduit. So if you happen to rotate that into position,
I'll try and get it straight.
Try your hardest.
There we go, converted that to an eyelid fit. I think that looks pretty good as well.
It does. And I think over time, so I took both of them out of the box. Okay, it's the first time I fitted both products, and that's the way I like to do it, so it's a fair comparison. But with all the nice little touches in the box from JCC, with it being dissembled and all the rest of it, I still think I would have got quicker installing these. And this is where we want your feedback. Have you been fitting the radial lead from JCC? If you have, leave it below, and how much quicker you think they are to fit.
Yeah, and if you've got a project coming up that needs 10 fitting, Gary will be more than happy to come along and show you how fast it is. Check out the full review we made on this product that looks in depth at some of those great design features in there. I will leave a link in the description below.